makes you feel super comfy while sitting. Your hands can be on your knees or in your lap. We're just taking some time to breathe and bring ourselves into a little yoga space. Okay, so you're just going to be breathing normally in through the nose, out through the mouth. And today we're going to be imagining ourselves sort of creating a bubble of sacred space, so we can make our yoga time just very personal and ours, really. Even if people are faffing around in the background, we're just creating this imaginary bubble around us. So as you're breathing in, your eyes are closed, you're relaxing, sitting up nice and straight, shoulders into their sockets, and you're going to imagine with each breath that you pull in, it's almost like you're starting to fill a little orb. So it's going to start like small, 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 just here at your center. And each breath is going to expand it, expand it, expand it, start to encompass your body, start to encompass your mat, and then give yourself a bit of space around the edges of your mat as well. So you're just creating a huge, big orb just for you. You can imagine any kind of color. You can pull in any kind of energy into your orb. So maybe you want to imagine that your orb is filled with warmth, with joy, with laughter. You might want to imagine divine love energy pulling in and surrounding all your space in your orb. Whatever is feeling good for you today. sacred orb is going to stay in place until the end of our practice today. So you've just created yourself a space to work in, full of the good juju that you require today. If you've got a cushion that you like to sit on, just toss it out your way. And come to sitting on your bum. You can sit in easy seat or free seat, whichever is more comfortable. The difference between the two is Sukhasana, you have your ankles under your legs. In free seat, your ankles are both sitting on the floor. So it's just a bit wider. It's the only difference between the two. Alrighty, so let's sit up nice and straight. Feel like you're lifting through the spine. Feel like you're lifting up the sides of your body. We're not pushing our chest forward, but just lifting it up. So it's almost like we're trying to, you imagine your hips being this bowl, and we're just lifting out the bowl for a bit. Arms are straight on the legs, and we're just gonna do little circles. First going towards the right and around. Feel the tummy. So we've created the sacred space to create this ability. Hopefully you would be able to do it at home anyway, to really allow yourself to pull into your inner world. So I'd like you to pay attention to your body today. You know, when you're moving around in circles, where are you clocking? Is it pain? Is it discomfort? Is it a nice stretch? Is it just a sensation that you're aware of? You're going to be paying attention to things like that. As we move through the different asana, you know, I'm going to be holding them a little bit longer, and we're going to be doing them in a little bit of a more controlled manner to give you a chance to gain, where am I feeling this? Which leg? Is it the back of the leg, the front of the leg? Is it both, but one was screaming louder, but as I hold it, I can feel the other one pulling in? Things like that. So we're really focusing on self-awareness today and feelings inside the body. Okay, so do your circles in the opposite direction, so towards the left first. Keep lifted in your belly. Your neutral position, bringing your knees together, returning to the side of on the side of our mats. The feet can be sort of, imagine a foot's length away from you, but the aim is not to get it right into your bum right now. We're going to hold on to our right knee and lift the left knee just up, so it's sort of 90 degree towards the floor. Foot is flexed and we're just lifting it. You want to be feeling the tummy tucking and sucking backwards. So the coccyx are tucking under, and then put that leg down. We go over to the right leg, lift again about a 90 degree. You're just holding it in the air. Over to the first leg. The more you do it, just pay attention to where it is that it starts to burn or progressively moves to burning. There's no right or wrong, it's just where it's affecting your body. Other leg. First leg. Now we're just going to push that foot away from us slightly, so not to have a straight leg, it's just slightly straighter. And pull it back. Straighten. Ish. Pull it back. Straighten ish. Pull back. Swap legs. Straighten ish. on the floor. Slowly, and again, we're working on control. So you want to feel the coccyx tucking under and that belly sucking back towards the lower back. So you can feel the lower back opening up towards the floor, you can imagine, and we're slowly rolling down towards the floor as best you can. Bringing your arms with you. So once you're nicely flat on the floor and the arms are extending up to the roof, we're just going to do a very subtle movement, again focusing in on our lower tummy muscles. So you might actually just want to feel your tummy muscles when we start. You know, are they kind of chilled or soft feeling? And then as you tuck those hips under, so you're feeling the coccyx tucking under, you're trying to pull your back onto the floor and you're pushing your arms away, but we'll come back to the arms so that you can quickly come here. Ah, there we go. That's all nice and active. And then you come back to the arms, pushing away. Then we relax, bringing our arms to our sides like we're a little cactus. And then we tuck and push away. We're gonna bring in our breath now. So as we inhale, the hands are dropping towards the floor, the tummy's relaxing. Exhale, we push away, tucking the hips under. So this is getting nice and firm. Cactus arms, inhale. Exhale, push away. You want to feel the, even these muscles under our arms active, so the arm is really pushing and getting firm. Inhale. Inhale. And this time we're going to bring our left knee up as we push away. Down. Right knee. Down. Should be feeling our tummies and our arms. Left knee. Inhale. Right knee. Really feel the tummy working. Inhale. Left knee. Inhale. Right knee. Inhale. As you exhale, we're doing left knee followed by right knee. So we're just helping ourselves, so we're not bringing both legs together just yet. So we exhale, left knee, right knee. Push away. So if you're trying to push the ceiling off your body. And relax down, inhaling. This time it'll be right knee, left knee. Exhale. Inhale. Left, right. Inhale. Right, left. Inhale. Left, right. Inhale. Right, left. Inhale. Now get ready. We're going to lift both knees at the same time. And we're going to hold it for a little bit. Really focusing on pulling your tummy muscles towards the floor. So they're nice and active and strong. And we're going to take an inhale before we exhale. As you exhale, you bring both knees up and arms up towards the ceiling. Push the ceiling away. And inhale down. Again. Holding. in towards your chest. Roll from side to side a little bit. And we're going to keep a hold of our left knee. So you again want to create space at your hip flexor, so you're sucking the tummy down towards the floor. Pull this knee in towards the chest as tight as you can. And the right knee gets lifted up towards the ceiling. It's fine if it's not sitting exactly 90 degrees because we're slowly lowering it. So feel like you're activating your bum muscle. So you want to feel the knee turning slightly outwards. So even your foot turns slightly out, a little bit like Charlie Chaplin. You're keeping the foot active or flexed. And very slowly, like a snail, you're going to slowly drop it down towards the floor. Keeping your tummy active. You just go as far as you can comfortably go, and then you bring it very slowly back up. And slowly up. Bend your knee into your chest and swap legs. Turn that knee slightly outwards so you have your Charlie Chaplin feet. And very slowly start lowering it to the floor. Just as far as you can go, and then you lift back up again. And we go back up. Slowly, like a snail. Towards your armpits, and we go into our happy baby pose, pulling the feet down towards the floor, trying to get those knees to go past our armpits. Start doing our spinal roll. So again, we think about rounding the whole of our back, holding onto the shins of our knees, and we're going to give ourselves a little bit of a rock backwards to help us start going forwards. Up we come, and down. Up we come. To feel your spine on the floor the whole way through the roll. one more, and we're going to keep staying on our coccyx with our feet lifted. So we're going into a bent-legged baby boat position. So you again keep the tummy lifted, arms extend out to the sides. And when you're doing this, you want to feel this arm being pulled away from you, because it's something about lengthening that actually helps us stay in that balancing space. So the arms pull away from you, you lift in the belly, and you just hold it in this position. Slowly start opening the legs away from you and the upper body away from you. So it's as if you're lowering to the ground, and then come back up. And open up. And come back up. And open. And come back up. We're going to hold on to our right knee or under the knee. And straighten the left leg out, swap legs, and straighten the right out. We're staying on those coccyx. Straighten left, straighten right, straighten left, straighten right. And we're going to go back to our spinal rolls. And on our next spinal roll, we're going to roll up into our squat. If you struggle with this, you just come into your squat. The world won't end. So you roll back, roll forward, squat. You're trying to get your shoulders through the legs, but if they're not there and you're sitting on your tippy toes and just extending your hands out in front of you, that's perfect. This is a move that we're working towards being able to sit flat-footed and shoulders through. Oh, moving around like that makes my bum feel uncomfortable. Oh, okay, there we go. And just sit here for a moment. Bringing awareness into the body. Where are you feeling things? What are you feeling in those areas? And gently rock up over onto your tippy toes. Pulling your hands closer, so you're trying to lengthen through the spine while sitting on the tippy toes. The knees are obviously jutting out towards the side. And you want to find a spot in front of you that you can focus on to help you with balance. Keeping a hold of that spot, slowly start lifting up. Squeeze the bum muscles, stay on your tippy toes. Lengthen your arms up towards the ceiling. And drop down onto your flat feet. If you're not at the front of your mat, just take a step to the front. Come into your Utkatasana. Again, lift in the belly, tuck the hips. Bring your hands into your heart center. And we push our hands together. And this is again just something to help us with our balance. We're going to lean into the right leg. Lift the left knee towards the chest. Just hold this for a moment. Then we're sending the left knee back, getting ready to get into our high lunge. Ooh. Try not to lose your balance. Remember to squeeze this back bum muscle. keeping our hands into our heart. We're straightening the front leg. So we're moving into our pyramid position and slowly leaning over that front leg. Keep that point in front of you in your sight to help you with your balance. Front knee again, and dropping the back knee. We're going to lean a little bit deeper into the front knee, keeping our hands in our prayer position, and then lean back into our half split, but we're keeping our front foot on the floor rather than lifting and flexing. Lean forward. Lean back. Lean forward. This time lean forward, but just until your knee is at about a 90 degree angle, and we're going to place our left hand on the floor, so it's in the inside of our right foot. And you can see we're not in a deep low lunge, we're just in a slight low lunge. Remember to keep using your left bum cheek, and we're going to rotate our sternum towards the right knee, opening up the hand up towards the ceiling, and then bring it down towards the floor to touch on the inside of the right foot as well, and then lift back up again and touch down, lift back up again, touch down, lift back up again. And we're going to allow the front knee to lean more forward as we turn open towards the left into our Skandasana, which is our half squat, extending our other leg out to the side. And you should be feeling a nice stretch happening on the inner thigh. Hands extend out in front of you. If you're on your tippy toes, because flat foot is a bit difficult, you're good. You're still in the right position. And just hold it and breathe here. Gently lean forward into your hands to help you lift up higher in that right knee, and then drop back down. Lean forward and lift, drop back down. Lean forward and lift, and swap over to the other side. Out that straightened leg, feeling the stretch coming into the inner thigh. lifting up in the left leg and back down. Lean forward, lift up and back down. Lean forward, lift up and over towards the right again. So we're now going to create a bit of movement. So we do our Skandasana, lean forward, lift up and over to the left. Skandasana, lean forward, lift up and over to the right. Lift up, over to the left. And we lean forward and start turning our bodies towards the left, bringing ourselves into that low lunge position. And we're working backwards here. So again, you want sort of a 90 degree rather with the legs rather than a deep low lunge. Right hand stays on the inside of the left foot. And then we extend the left hand up, twisting towards the left. Bring it back down to the inside of the left foot and twist. Back down. Twist. Back down. Now get ready to go back into our deep forward lunge, hands into our hearts. And then, find your balance. And lean back into your half splits. Hands in your heart. Lean forward. And back. Lean forward. Forward, lifting up into your high lunge. If you need to bounce this leg forward a bit, do what you need to. Hands are into our heart still. We're going to straighten that front leg. Find that point in front of you that you're focusing on to help you with your balance. And start leaning forward into your pyramid pose. Is bad on this side, guys. Sorry. Maybe let's try bringing my foot a little bit closer. One more time. Leaning forward. And up we come. Back into that forward lunge position and get ready, keeping your hands into your heart. Remember, we keep pressing the hands in to help us with our balance, and we're leaning forward to bring that back leg up towards the chest as we stand, holding it. Bend the left knee as you bring that foot back down to the floor, back into your Utkatasana. Lengthen up, keeping your hands in prayer position. And up onto your tippy toes. Keeping the feet together, but the knees opening. Keeping on your tippy toes as you drop down into your Malasana. Keeping the back straight, lengthening up through the spine. Remember, finding that one spot to stare at helps you with your balance in these poses. Keep leaning forward if you're able to, and you bring your shoulders down through your legs. Remember, you just go as far as you're able and comfortable. We're going to drop down onto our bum, into a couple of spinal rolls, sucking belly down towards the spine, rounding our back, and up, down and up. And our third one, we're going to throw ourselves forward to come to standing again. As long as you're coming to standing at the end of it, you're fine. Alrighty, and we're going to work on, I'm actually going to face you guys with this one because we're not going to be standing backwards, but we're working again on balance as well as getting into our tummy muscles. Okay, so I'll do one facing you and then I'll do one sideways, whichever helps. So we're going to stand into the left leg. If you need to bend it slightly to feel more secure and stable, then you do so. You lift the right leg up sort of 90 degree. I always say sort of because it's difficult to gauge when you don't have a mirror. You could be sitting here thinking you're at 90 degree, but so you're trying to feel your way. Then we're going to place our left hand on top of the right knee and you're creating tension. So the knee is pushing into the hand is pushing into the knee. And you want to feel the tummy muscles activating. Your bum muscles activating, your bum muscles activating. This is just, this whole area is waking up or continuing to be awake. Okay, so you push in, feeling tummy muscles. Push in, feeling tummy muscles. And we're gonna dare to lean forward. Hands to heart into a warrior three position. It's okay if you struggle. Come back up. Push your hand into your knee and then swap feet. So now we're leaning into our right leg. Left leg comes up. Push your right hand into left knee. Feel the tummy muscles working. Slowly start leaning forward, hands into your heart, extend the back leg away from you, warrior three. We're not bringing the arms in, we're just keeping our hands to heart, it makes it a little bit easier. And up we come again, right hand into left knee, feel tummy working, and release. I'm hoping you guys are coping. We do it again. Remember, we tuck the coccyx down, lift in the belly. We're leaning into the right foot. Maybe went to left first. Really lift and push through that bum. Find your balance. Left knee, right hand. I'm doing the same leg again. And push through. Feel the tummy working. Feel the bum working. Slowly lean into your warrior three again. This time our hands are behind us. Imagine we're Supergirl. Alaska Day. Super cow. Slowly come up. Bring your hands up towards the ceiling and drop that leg down into the floor. Now we're going to stand and root through the left leg, squeezing the bum muscles. Lift the right knee up, left hand to right knee pushes. We feel our tummy working. three hands behind us, like super cow. Just do the best you can. We're gonna lift back up, bringing our hands up towards the ceiling. Our legs sort of just short of your yoga mat. Bend the knees, tuck your coccyx under, bringing your sternum or your torso onto the tops of your legs. Lean forward. You can grab onto your ankles like I am if you want to, or you can have them interlaced behind your back. It actually feels nice. Start straightening the legs, just slowly. Keep lifted in your tummy. Release the hands, and we're going to let them sweep down on the ground as we bend our knees. Our legs are wider, so it's a wide-footed Utkatasana. And then lean onto your right leg. Place the left back down. Lean over onto the left. Sweep back down. Straighten your legs, interlacing your hands behind you. Bend the knees, sweep down, back into your Utkatasana, lean into your right leg, lean into your left leg, sweep back down, interlace your fingers, straightening your legs. Last time, bend the knees, sweep the arms, Utkatasana, hold it, lean over onto your right foot, wrap the top leg around, going into our eagle. We're going to make the top legs, same arm, go underneath the other. Lift elbows up. Release. Back into your Utkatasana. Then lean over onto the left leg. Find your balance. Wrap the top leg around the bottom. And then the top, the same arm as the top leg, will now go on top with your arms. Release, Utkatasana, leaning forward, interlace your fingers and hang. The knees, sweeping hands, lift all the way up to standing, feel your body being pulled long, go into a very slight back bend, hands into heart, take a deep breath in. you mount to the floor, tucking the hips under. Onto your bum. And we're going to extend our legs straight out in front of us. Lift arms up towards the ceiling. Feel lifted in the tummy, feel lengthened through the spine, and lean forward, grabbing your toes, your ankles, or your calves. Make sure that your sternum is pulling towards your feet rather than your head. Your knees a bit, pulling your chest down towards your quads, and then try and straighten your legs a little bit and bend, straighten, bend, straighten, bend. Up and you can get ready for relaxation. Pop on some warm socks, maybe grab some blankies, pillows, whatever you need to feel cozy and warm. I'll just give you a few moments. I'm going to turn the music off to last, or rather very low, to really focus in on our own stuff. Okay, let's take our three deep breaths in and out, in through the nose, out through the mouth. In through the nose, out through the mouth, I'm hoping that you feel all nice and warm and wrapped up so that you can actually imagine yourself in this exquisitely silken woven cocoon. Allow yourself the space to really pull inside yourself and in this cocoon. Even imagining that as you're lying here, the last little bit of the opening of the cocoon is closing, giving you this time and space to really dissolve into yourself and emerge lighter, excited, whatever it is that you're requiring in your world at the moment. Breathe in. In each inhalation feels like you're bringing more and more of that metamorphic energy into your cocoon and allowing you to grow deeper into your introspection of self. Imagine where you feel your soul lies. Some people it's different. Some people feel it in their heart because they're governed by their heart, and so they feel their soul lives there. Some people are governed by their gut, and so they imagine their soul lives there. Some are governed by their mind. So go into your world and pay attention to where you feel your soul lives, and go and have a visit with your soul self. Imagine this very wise energy sitting waiting for you, like they've been waiting for you for centuries. And in their presence, you feel nothing but acceptance, peace, and absolute love. And you know that they are just filled with infinite wisdom and patience. And today, instead of asking questions, we're actually just going to sit with our soul selves. Allow that infinite kindness, that wisdom, and that love energy to sort of seep into you as you sit, kind of like rubbing shoulders. And as you feel this rubbing of shoulders, you can imagine yourself inside your cocoon as veins of this energy sprig out in every direction, maybe in exquisite, tantalizing colors, veining all around your cocoon, bringing this energy into this physical body of yours. Energy pulling in through your being. Take a moment to thank your soul self for the time you've spent together. And start bringing your body back to its cocooned self. Imagining that what you find here is a new body, something filled with these energies that you thought so awe-inspiring of your soul self. You've brought a piece of that back with you. Take a few deep breaths. Most reacquainting ourselves with our bodies. And before we start emerging from our cocoon, we remember the beautiful orb that we erected at the beginning of class. And instead of tearing it down, we're actually just going to allow it to grow small, like marble. Imagine it just shrinking so that you can store it with all the good juju that you placed inside of it, to use it whenever you feel like you need a little time out and space for yourself. Maybe think about tucking it inside your heart center. Maybe wherever your soul lies, you create a little storage space for your soul adventures. Once it's shrunk and stored away, you can imagine yourself pushing open the top of your little cocoon, making your way out back into the world. Bringing your awareness right here in this moment. You can feel the floor under your body. Take 3 deep breaths in and just allow yourself to bring that body and that soul back together now. Last breath, we start wiggling our fingers, wiggling our toes, giving our body one last stretch. Oh, and slowly come up to your seated position. Your hands can be on your knees or into your heart center as we do our closing om. Deep breath in. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.